Hello everyone. So in this video, I will be explaining the poem titled Silence, written by Marianne Moore. Marianne Moore is one of the important or celebrated American poet, translator and critic. She is known for her wonderful use of innovative diction and irony in her poetry. So in this video, I will be analyzing her poem Silence. The poem is narrated by a young girl who remembers her father and the guidance or suggestions given by her father when she is growing up. She tells about one of the important quality one should employ in his or her life as suggested by her father, that is the quality of silence. Silence is not a negative attribute to a person. Instead, silence can also be a strong weapon for a person. So throughout the poem, she recalls her father and suggestions given by her father. So in the very first line, she says, "My father used to say," when my father was with me, when he was with me, he used to say, he used to tell me that superior people never make long visits. So who are these superior people? We have to understand this first. Superior people here refers to people who are different from others. They are different from others because they do not belong to a particular crowd. They are different from others because they don't raise their voice every time to give their opinion. Instead, they remain silent and calm. Such people, they do not make long visits, which means they do not stay at one particular place for a long time. Their character is that, their feature is that they keep on traveling from one place to another place, exploring this world. Because these superior people, they understand the fact that the knowledge of a person increases not by staying at one particular place with a group of people for a long time, instead by traveling from one place to another place. Here, we must understand superior people are not people who are rich or who belong to upper class or who enjoy certain benefits because of their class affiliations. Instead, superior people are those people who employ the quality of silence in their lives. And these people, they do not stay at one place for a long time. Instead, they travel from one place to another place so that they can gain new knowledge. And these people, on the one hand, they travel from one place to another place. On the other hand, they will never disclose the fact that they have visited all these places. Because in the next line of the poem, you can see, superior people, they don't have to be shown Longfellow's grave or the glass flowers at Harvard. Though they have visited many places, they will never reveal the fact that they have visited all these places, such as Longfellow's grave, a famous poet, or they have visited a famous garden at Harvard University. So these people, they remain silent. They wait for the time. When the time arrives, then only they break that silence and they start speaking, which gives more value to their words. So these people, they do not stay at one place. They travel from one place to another place, but the irony is that they never reveal the fact that they have visited all these places. So in the next part of the poem, she again remembers her father and what he has said her. She tells, "Superior people are self-reliant like the cat." Her father used to say that superior people are like the cat. They are self-reliant. Cat hunts down its prey without depending on others. It will patiently wait. It will silently wait until its prey reaches a point of helplessness, and then it jumps on its prey and kills it, and that is how it becomes successful. So superior people are also self-reliant. They do not depend on others. They believe in their strength. They believe in their energy. And they will wait patiently for their time so that they can make their point clear. So finally, the cat, after waiting for a long time, it is successful in hunting down its prey and eating the mouse. And you can see the line, the mouse's limp tail hanging like a shoelace from its mouth, which says that because that cat was silent for a long time and patiently waited for a long time, it was successful in hunting down its prey. This is a very important quality in superior people. So she continues the same theme of how important it is to stay silent and what are the suggestions given by her father. She says that superior people, they sometimes enjoy solitude. This is a very important line. Solitude can be a bliss. For many people, they treat solitude or staying lonely or this loneliness or aloneness as a kind of punishment. But instead, superior people, they enjoy this solitude because solitude allows them to gain more knowledge. They can be enlightened in this solitude. If I can quote here certain thoughts of Rabindranath Tagore, the poet laureate, where he says, "The best Indian ideas have come when man was in communion with nature in silence." We can understand the same aspect here because superior people, they enjoy this solitude, which will allow them to get enlightened. The silent atmosphere, the patient atmosphere will allow them to gain more knowledge. And superior people, they can be robbed of speech. One can feel that they are robbed of speech, which means they are not speaking. They will never speak much. On the other hand, it is a deliberate act of the superior people of not speaking much. So they are robbed of speech at the outset, but on the other hand, it is their deliberate act of not speaking much. They will wait patiently for their turn when they can make their point clear to the other person. So superior people, they are robbed of speech. They keep quiet for a long time because this solitude will help them by getting a kind of delight. A very important statement here. The solitude or staying silent for a long time will definitely allow them to get kind of delight in their life. Because the deepest feelings in a person always shows or comes out when they are in silence. A very important line in the poem. The deepest feelings, the innermost feelings, a kind of self-realization happens in a person when he or she is silent. This state of meditation will allow that person to see his or her inner self, and that is very important to understand here, because silence is a virtue, is not a negative attribute in a person's life. The next line of the poem is very important because it is not just by being silent that they get delight or they get enlightened, but they get enlightened with the quality of restrain. What is the meaning of this word restrain? Restrain here refers to unemotional, dispassionate behavior, or to put it in simple terms, it is the act of self-control. A person has to be unemotional, dispassionate. We should restrain ourselves from passionate behavior. We should restrict ourselves from the emotions. We should be unemotional, we should be dispassionate, and we should control our feelings. We should restrain our feelings, which gives a kind of enlightenment in a person. So the quality of silence is highlighted throughout the poem, which gives a person real knowledge. He or she will never raise his or her voice. They will wait patiently like a cat. They will wait in silence, the moment which gives them a kind of delight or enlightenment. So last two lines of the poems are very, very interesting, where she remembers some important lines of her father, where he used to say, nor was he insincere in saying. She says that my father was very, very sincere, honest and prompt whenever he used to tell me that make my house your inn, because inns are not residences. A very important suggestion given by her father. Make my house your inn. Make sure that you treat my house where you are staying today like an inn, because inn is not a permanent residence. Inn is a lodging facility where we stay for some time for food and drink by paying some money. So treat my home or my house like an inn, because I don't want you to stay here permanently. You have to move on. You have to go out. You have to explore this world so that you can also become a superior person. So make sure that you make my house an inn instead of permanent resident. A very important suggestion given by her father at the end of the poem. So in this way, we can analyze this poem Silence by Marianne Moore, where she tells about one of the important quality we should attribute in our life, that is quality of silence. Because silence is not weakness. Instead, silence can allow a person to get delight or to enlighten in his or her life. Thank you.